the tree, how much fun it's gonna be together. This Christmas, fireside's blazing bright. We're caroling through the night. And this Christmas will be a very special Christmas for me. Presents and cards are here. My world is filled with cheer and
welcome to the Bart Clark Christmas Special. So glad you're joining me. Christmas Eve and all through the house, not a creature is stirring. Okay, there are three creatures stirring in my house. Three dogs named Brownie, Lady, and Rocket. Excuse me. Welcome to the show, man. And are you ready for Christmas? I know the shopping is still going on. The wife is still in full shopping mode. I'm done. I'm broke, man. It's a wrap. I'm kind of embarrassed because this year the money just did not work out. You know, it's going to be a whole bunch of personal hugs and kisses as opposed to amazing gifts, which I don't mind. It's okay. You know what? I would love to not buy gifts for the kids and put that money away. Here's an idea. We don't do gifts for the kids of the family, but families pledge to pay for the college education of all the kids. So you get little gifts, but you don't get the crazy, stupid, expensive, don't count gifts. So in other words, a Mac, sure. An expensive bag, no. Expensive clothes or tennis shoes, no. A decent phone, okay. See what I'm saying? Like things that make sense. And then the main thrust would be that everybody, all the young folks, have a college fund that guarantees them to go to college. And if they're good students, to a college of their choice. That's what I'm talking about. That's what I'd like to get to. Now, will that happen in our family? No. I'm sorry. It's just not going to. But the kids are going to go to college. So, you know, they're going to go to a college of their choice. I'm just saying, in theory, for all the family kids, that would be the move. So as we, you know, celebrate Christmas, next, let's hop into 2016. Not too heavy, because that'll be another show. But some of the things that stood out in 2016, and, you know, we'll mix those thoughts and comments with some good records, some good music, and it'll be all good.
Christmas. return every year, every Christmas. I come here every year, every Christmas.
Lee Luther Vandross, one of our favorites. Every year, every Christmas. Looks like a couple different stats here for Christmas. The average, in 2013, a survey revealed that the U.S. customers expected to spend about $704 on average for Christmas gifts. And then this year, like $830. Now, the most they ever spent, or in recent history, in 99, the average was around $857. And then in 2007, 2008, when we were all balling, it was like $866. Now, that was a survey taken in 2013. Now, a Gallup poll showed that people this year were going to spend more, and $830, which was up from that $720 we mentioned. And another survey showed that people are spending less for individual gifts, which I like that idea. You know what I'm saying? Don't go crazy. Don't go crazy, son. So it looks like the consumers are buying less expensive gifts. I know that's been the case for me and the wife as far as our gifts for each other for the last 5 years. We kind of say, hey, look, $100, don't go crazy, and let's just do $100. And then, of course, I always try to do better to surprise. But the survey says the number of people willing to buy gifts during this holiday shopping season for under $10 rose to 4% this year from 1% last year. According to a survey of 1,000 people by America's Research Group, a firm that researches consumer behavior, the number of people willing to spend between $26 and $35 fell to 18%. From 22%. Overall, people are expected to spend modestly more this holiday season. And, you know, the National Retail Federation predicts holiday spending in November and December will be up 3.7% to $630.5 billion. So I guess it depends on what survey you take, what's going on. This song right here, when I hear this, it's Christmas.
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, like the one that I used to know. Honey, it's where the treetops glisten. Little bitty children, they're trying to listen to hear for the sleigh bells that are ringing in the snow. I wanna tell you one more time what I'm thinking about. I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, yeah. Christmas card that I write you, oh, want you to know, Mayo Day, Mayo Day, it's all. All of your Christmas and me all. Christmases be so white, I'm all white. I'm dreaming of a white Christmas.
The late Otis Redding, White Christmas. Gift ideas, looking at the New York Post this year, it's probably too late, but just so you know, 360 Fly video camera. This panoramic video camera, a great gift for any photographer or action fan. I did not see that out. This is Buzzy Cookies, Chef Jacques Torres, known for making one of the city's best chocolate chip cookies, started selling at home mix at the end of August and is already selling as well as the baked cookies. They're called Chocolate Chip Cookie Mix, $18 at Jacques Torres. Okay, interesting. This coveted cookware, it's a soap stone cooking pot. And it's like from $60 to $114 at Whisk NYC.com. They've been making them in Brazil for like 400 years, and they started to get hot in the U.S. It's soapstone. So soapstone cooking pots or cookware. Now, my clothing fans, this plaid dress seems to be all the rage. Vineyard Vines CEO and co-founder Shep Murray says this wool plaid party dress, $228 at Vineyard Vines right here at 1151 3rd Avenue in New York. All the fan fave stuff from Star Wars is really hot. Those little socks for dogs. Have you seen those? Those are really hot. And they're like $25, but they're, you've seen them. They're little, like shoes for the snow, for your babies, for your dogs. What else? Anything else catch my eye? A must-have cookbook that's hot is Chef Yotam Ottolenghi's book. Apparently, he has these huge cooking books. Nopi, the cookbook, $35. It's at Strand Bookstore, 828 Broadway. You can still get that. Cool Drinks, the Pappy Van Winkle of Ciders, is what Craig Kanarek, CEO of Mouth.com, calls the hard-to-keep-in-stock tipples coming out of the Aaron Burr Cidery. They're nuanced like a fancy champagne. Little cider. Now, of all those things I mentioned, I'd get none of them except the doggy socks or the doggy shoes. That's how I roll. You know? What about you?
"'Twas the night before Christmas, and all through the house, not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse.
In my mind, for all of our friends,
hear what I say. We wish you a Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas to all of you.
from the Temptations.
And Merry Christmas from me to you, to your family. Have a great time, and I will see you right after Christmas. We got a lot of things jumping off, and we look forward to 2016. Be blessed, and I'll talk to you soon.